Hey all, welcome to Azure IaaS Today Digital Event. This is our session on disk storage. My name is ZRS Kutian. I lead the product management for Azure Disks. In this session, I'll go over how Azure Disks can help increase scalability, performance, and availability for your business critical workloads. I will share our latest innovations and show a couple of cool demos as well. Azure Storage is durable, meaning we make multiple replicas of every data return. It's also highly available and massively scalable. Azure Disk is our block storage offering. It is designed for business critical applications like SAP HANA, top tier databases, and other transaction heavy workloads. To highlight a few strengths of our platform, number one, Azure Disk have the industry leading durability. We literally delivered 0% annual failure rate, which means we never lost customer data. Secondly, we have the best single instance VM SLA for SSD disks. Third, we have the REST API support for block storage, which lets our ISVs build really rich, advanced experience for scenarios like backup, migration, and DR, which they cannot do on any other platform. Lastly, we also have shared disk and ZRS, which are truly differentiated offers, providing high availability for your mission critical workloads. And I'll talk more about that in later slides. In Azure Disk, we have four types of disk offerings. For your most IO intensive and demanding workloads, like SAP HANA, Ultra Disk delivers the best performance and it offers the ability to configure capacity, IOPS throughput independently and dynamically scale the performance up and down so you get the optimal performance and cost for your workload needs. Premium SSD is our default disk offering. It gives you the right balance of performance and cost, and it's ideal for majority of your enterprise production workloads. For other workloads that need consistent performance but not as IO intensive, we have another option of SSDs called standard SSDs. It's ideal for workloads like web servers or lightly used enterprise applications like smaller databases. For other low-cost storage scenarios, we also have standard HDD. It could be used for things like backup or test dev, which doesn't require the highest performance. So as I was saying, Azure Disk can be used for a wide range of use cases and scenarios. If your workload falls into any of these categories shown here, you can find the right solution on Azure. For example, your most IO intensive workloads, the right solution will be Ultra Disk. For your most other generic enterprise production workloads, you could use premium SSD disks. For scenarios like cluster applications, such as SQL FCI, you can leverage our shared disks, which come with the full support for clustering with SCSI, PR, and so on. And with our new disk pool offering, you can also access the high-performance durable block storage from Azure VMware solutions. Azure Disk Storage enables customers to scale to meet the demand while also providing the optimal performance for their workloads. I want to highlight some of the latest innovations in this space. We have now doubled the Ultra Disk throughput to 4,000 MB per second. That is a single Ultra Disk can deliver up to 4 GB per second of traffic. Of course, you also need the latest VM series like EV5, currently in preview, to drive that high throughput. Or you could also spread the load across multiple VMs using shared Ultra Disks. Next, let me show you a quick demo of how to set the 4,000 MB per second throughput on Ultra Disk. So in this demo, I'm going to show how to create an Ultra Disk with 4,000 MB per second throughput. So I'm on Create a Resource View on Portal, and I'm going to create a Manage Disk. I'm going to choose West US2 region, which is where I want to create the Ultra Disk. And I'm going to choose the right resource group in the region. And let me give a name for this disk. And I need to also pick an availability zone where I'm on the Ultra Disk. And now I want to pick Ultra Disk. So by default, it shows premium. So let me switch to Ultra. And here I can choose the disk size, IOPS, and throughput I want. So I want to go with really high IOPS. Let's say I want to use 120,000 IOPS. And now I need to specify the throughput. So here I'm going to go with 4,000 MB per second. Click OK and review and create. And the validation pass and creation is now going through. It will take just a moment for the creation to go through, maybe a minute or so. Then the Ultra Disk will be created and ready to use from that point onwards. Once it's ready, yeah, it's already done. I can go back to the overview of the disk. And if I go back home, that is it. I can see the disk here. And you can see the performance on the disk. You can see here it's an Ultra Disk, 1 gigabyte size and 4000 MB per second throughput. It's very quick. You could, of course, use PowerShell, CLI, or API as well. Now, I want to share an example of how a customer is using Ultra Disk to achieve the high performance they need for their mission-critical workload. P&G is a leader in CPG industry with iconic brands such as Tide, Gillette, Dawn, and many more. They were looking to move a mission-critical manufacturing application to the cloud. It was a complex process because of the performance requirements. With the high IOPS and throughput of Ultra Disk, they were able to successfully migrate to Azure and achieve performance that matched or exceeded what they were seeing on-premises. P&G also took advantage of the flexibility that Ultra Disk provides to dynamically change the performance without any downtime. Now I want to highlight the performance scaling capabilities that Azure Disk offers and that enables you to scale your performance cost-effectively. For usual unplanned scenarios where you need high performance for a short period of time, we currently offer two bursting capabilities, credit-based bursting for small disks and virtual machine bursting. Both are suitable for typical scenarios like improving boot times or processing small batch jobs that may need an IO spike or any other unexpected traffic spikes that may come your way. So this capability is available to you at no additional cost, and it's based on credit-based system where you can burst to a peak performance for up to 30 minutes in a day. The bursting allows you to provision your VMs and disks for your baseline average performance needs instead of max performance, allowing you to save your cost. Now, we recently announced the general availability of on-demand disk bursting. This is a unique capability only offered on Azure. It allows you to burst your performance much higher and at any time without worrying about the burst credits. For on-demand bursting, there is a small fee to enable it, and then there will be a charge for additional transactions that go above the provision limit. This feature is ideal for smoothly handling infrequent and unpredictable traffic spikes. For example, your 1 TB disk occasionally needs a spike to 20,000 IOPS or 1,000 MB per second. You can do that cost effectively by enabling on-demand bursting instead of provisioning high throughput of IOPS all the time on the disk. Now, what do you do if you need the high performance for a long period of time? For example, for an event like Black Friday or running performance testing or training environment where you need to maintain high performance for a few hours or days. That is where performance tiers come in. The third column listed here. We have this great new feature to increase the disk performance by going to a higher performance tier for premium disk without increasing the actual disk size. And you can lower the tier later when you don't need it anymore. So instead of using a larger disk at a high cost to meet a peak performance, you can use a small disk along with performance tiers, which means you pay for higher performance tier only when you need it. This also helps lower your cost and lets you achieve the high performance your workload may need anytime. Along with scaling the performance to meet the demand, there might be scenarios where you need to grow your disk size as your data footprint grows or your performance requirements change. Customers can now dynamically increase their disk size without any downtime to their applications with the live resize capability in preview. Live resize gives you the confidence that you can deploy a disk today and easily make changes in the future without disrupting your workloads. So next, I'm going to demo live resize. So I'm going to use this VM. As you can see, it's a running VM. And let's look at the disks. It has two data disks. Both are premium SSD, one LRS, one ZRS. And I'm going to probably I'll use the first one for the demo. And let's go into the details. And let's go into size and performance. And I'm using Portal for the demo. You could, of course, do the same with a PowerShell CLI or API. So to increase the disk size, all I have to do is to go to this view, and this is the place it shows the disk size, and I can edit the disk size. Let's say I want to go with 1,000 gigabyte, and click resize, and it's updating the disk. Sometimes it will take a few moments to go through. I have an RDP running on the VM, and I want to show what we have on that VM. So this is a VM, and as you can see here, you can see the same disks here. This is the original disk, 900 gig, and you can see the second disk as well. And that is the volumes, and these are the disks here as well, 956. Let's see if our disk size increase is complete or not. So I'm going to refresh the disk here. See, as you can see, the disk size is now 1,000. That's the live resize we did. What you could do next is to go into the volumes, because volume size is still showing 900 here. So you can just right click on it and extend the volume. And as you can see, current size is 900, but you have now new max size of 1,000 because you expanded the disk size. And I can enter 1,000 here and expand that volume to the new size that I resized it to. And if I go here and refresh it, now this is also 1,000. We continue to make investments to further improve the reliability of our infrastructure. And we also make new solutions available to customers for improving the availability of their workloads. So a unique capability that is now generally available on Azure is zone-redundant storage for Azure disks. Typically, block storage solutions use a locally redundant storage, where we use multiple replicas within a single zone. Now, we have a second option for redundancy to use ZRS, which spreads the replicas across three different zones in a region. ZRS provides the industry's only synchronous replication of block storage across three zones in a region, enabling your disks to tolerate zonal failures, which might occur due to natural disasters or hardware issues. Now imagine using ZRS disk in a shared disk configuration, attaching the same ZRS disk to VMs in three different zones, providing your workload with the ultimate protection for high availability, only possible on Azure. The configuration may look something like this. The scenario is using ZRS for clustered or distributed applications like SQL Server FCI or SAP ACS SCS, leveraging Windows Server Failover cluster with a combination of shared disk and ZRS. Here, you have a shared ZRS disk, which has replicas in all three zones, mounted to two VMs in two different availability zones, with the idea that if there is a failure in any data center or any zone that impacts a VM, the other VM will continue to function and provide high availability for your workload. And the disk is continued to be available as well. Next, let me do a quick demo of how to configure ZRS and shared disk for a clustered configuration. For this demo, I want to show how to configure shared disk with ZRS for a high availability configuration. So I'm going to use a couple of VMs I have in this resource group. Let me group them. So I have two VMs in this resource group. This VM1, let's look at VM1. See, it's in availability zone 1. And let's also look at the disks in that VM. It has one premium ZRS disk. You can see disk name, my shared ZRS disk 1. So let me go back and look at the second VM. That VM is in availability zone 2. And it has the same disk attached to that. My shared ZRS disk 1 attached to the same VM. So in this configuration, you have two VMs in two availability zones pointing to the same ZRS disk. And the two VMs are running Windows Server Failover Cluster. And Windows Server Failover Cluster handles the shared cluster configuration for that VM. It sets the right SCSI PR permissions, and it takes care of all the clustering and access control on those disks. So this, as you can see, this is a very simple, straightforward configuration, two VMs in two zones, and the same disk attached to both VMs in the shared disk configurations. So let's talk about a few scenarios where you can leverage ZRS and shared disks. Here's a scenario using a ZRS disk with multi-zone AKS clusters. So customers can leverage ZRS disk for their container applications hosted on multi-zone AKS for high reliability. The idea is that if a zone goes down, AKS will automatically fail over the stateful part to a healthy zone by detaching and attaching the ZRS disk to nodes in the healthy zone. You can also use ZRS to achieve higher availability for legacy applications. You know, some of the legacy applications don't support application level synchronous replications. So in that case, ZRS disk will provide the improved availability through storage level replication. ZRS and shared disk can also be used to achieve maximum availability for clustered SAP applications. We recently added support for the SAP scenarios with shared disks. Recap the key takeaways. Number one, Ultra Disk provides the high performance, low latency for your most demanding workloads. Number two, you can easily scale your performance and capacity without downtime to adapt to changing workload needs along with bursting capabilities. And number three, you can increase the availability for your critical workloads with ZRS and shared disks on Azure. Finally, to learn more about Azure Disk Storage, please check out the resources listed here. We have great content and documentation for you to explore in more detail. Thank you for watching this session. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have feedback, feel free to reach out to Azure Disk team. It's azuredisk@microsoft.com.